Yes, thank you for joining us on time. Now I call upon Dhanalakshmi to address the speaker. Over to Dhanalakshmi.
A very warm and wonderful evening to one and all gathered here for the webinar session. On behalf of IEEE Panimalar Institute of Technology Student Branch, I, JP Dhanalakshmi, a second year student from ECE department, is very happy and all for the energetic minds for today's webinar. It is indeed my honor to invite our speaker for today's webinar, Mr. M. Mohammad Suhail, to give a talk on the topic, A Complete Roadmap for Placement. M. Mohammad Suhail is currently working as an assistant professor and placement coordinator in the Department of Computer Science, Alpha Arts and Science College, Chennai. He is currently pursuing his doctoral degree from B.S. Abdul Rahman Crescent Institute, Science and Technology. He has started his teaching career as an assistant professor in the Department of MCA, Wales College of Science. His thirst for knowledge in the field of computer science has created another dimension in his career as a technical placement trainer. So far, he has trained more than 3,000 plus students for placements. Most of the students are well placed in top MNCs companies. Adding merits to his profession, he has also acted as a corporate trainer for HCL employees and trained them Oracle SQL at Digitality Corporate Training Center, Chennai. His mission is to build an ecosystem for college students that nurtures them into masterful technology manipulators and provides them with opportunities for developing technological solutions to local problems. Adding to his mission, he has started his own channel named Suhail Classroom in YouTube to share his technical skills and ideas to the student across the nation. We are very much glad to have you here, sir. We are thankful to you for accepting our invitation to present this webinar. Now, participants, tighten your belts. Here comes an interesting session for you all where M. Mohammad Suhail will explain you a complete roadmap for placement. Without any further delay, I now hand over the session to the speaker. Please, sir.
Good evening to one and all present here. Can you hear my voice? My
voice is audible. Yes. Yes, sir.
Okay. So good evening to all. First of all, let me extend my sincere thanks to the management of Panimalar Institute of Technology, and then my sincere thanks to Dr. M. Chitra, head of the department ECE, and then Mr. Arun, assistant professor ECE department, and then the student coordinators Ramya, Sri, Dhanalakshmi for their support for this event, and then all the other faculty members of the department and the various participants from the institute. Okay, I sincerely thank you all for giving me this wonderful opportunity and a platform to expose my skills and talent, which will be helpful for your career. So can we start the show?
Yes, sir, of course.
Okay, and in the beginning itself, I'll tell you, like, it will be a very interesting session. It won't be like a theoretical class as you all used to have in your institute. So you can go and wash your face and come and sit, because since it is online class, like online session, you people have a lot of fun out there. Okay, forget all those fun. This 1 hour what we are going to spend on placement is going to be a worthwhile one for you. Okay, and I request all of you to sincerely watch the thing, and we'll have a lot of interesting activities, okay, in between. So let's see. Okay, now can you all see my screen, shared screen?
Yes, sir.
My PPT?
Yes, sir.
So is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, fine. Now we'll start the thing. Okay, so first and foremost thing is about the worrying factors about placement. Like most of the colleges, whether it is Arts and Science College or Engineering College, out of the 100% of strength, only I could say 10 to 15% rarely get placed into the core companies. Okay, here the students may be from ECE, IT, CSE, and then biomedical, mechanical, EEE. So a lot of engineering streams are there. So you just think about your class. If you are in the third year, somebody might have got placed. And if you are in the final year, you think about your placement status so far. If you take in your class itself, you could see out of the 100% of strength, only a very few percentage of students only getting in the core companies. What about the remaining others? the remaining others does not get into the core company at all. Maybe they may be getting into the other related company. Some may be getting into like IT company. Some may be getting into like what banking job. Some might be pursuing their higher studies. Some might be like what going for some part-time jobs or whatever the job they are getting, like BPO, okay, marketing executive, all those things. So this is a very very much worrying fact that only very few percentage of students are getting placed. Okay, is it right or wrong? I need answer from your side. So third year students are here, final year, third year. See, let us have an interactive session so that it will be very useful for us. Like instead of one way communication, if it is a two-way communication, that will be much interesting. You can unmute yourself and you can speak.
Yes, sir. Yeah.
May I know your name, please?
Krishna Prashant.
You are from?
I'm a pre-finalist student from Panimala Institute of Technology.
Okay. Have you got placed?
Sir, only by August the placements are beginning for us.
Okay, fine. Very good. So, what about your previous, have you discussed with your seniors about their placements? How many of them got placed? Any interaction with seniors?
Yes, sir. Many of them have been placed in CTS, Avasoft,
okay,
and companies like that.
Okay, fine. Okay, so the thing is, like, that's good. Now, since you haven't got any placement, so placement is yet to happen. So this is a first thing you must understand, that you must get into core companies. Every one of you attending this attending this particular session, have it in mind that you must get into the core companies, because that's the reason you are getting into a particular stream of engineering. Okay, whether it is biomedical or electrical or triple E or mechanical, whatever stream it might be. So you have to get into the core companies. So that should be your main factor. Now, why is that very few students are only getting placed in core companies? That's what you're going to see in the next slide. Why? What is the reason behind very less percentage of students are getting placed in core companies? Like, you could see various factors. Okay. So the first and foremost factor I could say is the students are very playful. Okay, so they are not at all listening and attending to the class, what the teachers are taking, you know. So they are not good in subject knowledge. That's the main reason. Okay, do you agree with this, all the points which I mentioned regarding the very few placement in many colleges across the country, or you could say in Tamil Nadu? Why this is happening? Because of these factors. Do you all agree with this? Just see the slide and tell me. All the points whichever I have given is absolutely right, or can you add few more points apart from this? So you people will be playful, not listening to the class properly. That might be one of the factors, yes or no? Not taking serious about your subject, your degree program, that may result in what? Not getting placed. That's the first thing, playful. Okay, and then because of this playfulness and not listening to the class, you won't get any subject knowledge. That is the main reason for not showing any interest upon your placement. And then the third most important point that has to be addressed is, all of you most probably will be addicted to social media. Okay, so you'll be sitting day and night in the social media, like chatting with your friends, posting, uploading photos, all those things, and spending your valuable time on that. So you won't be gaining knowledge in your subject. You won't be upgrading yourself in the area that you have chosen as your career. So next one is various distraction. Here it is a generalized term, various distraction, in the sense it may be family issues. Okay, it may be personal issues, psychological issues. Okay, some might be during the college days, they may be getting into some sort of indecent behavior or inappropriate behavior during the college days. That may be also another factor. So various distractions they do get during the college days, and the arrear plays a vital factor. Okay, so if you do have arrears, then you are not eligible to attend the campus placement. Okay, there are certain companies, they do agree with one or two arrears. But most of the MNC companies, top companies, they won't encourage students with arrears, because then there will be a huge competition for the particular job. Okay, so they have to filter the students though. So you need to what clear the arrears. So but since people are having arrears, so they cannot attend the placement. That might be one of the reason that they couldn't able to get placed. Okay, and then eligibility criteria, and one among that is arrear. Another, they might be what having nil arrear, but they would not be having the eligibility. For example, many IT companies, they would say like consistency 60% right from 10th standard. Your percentage should be 60 and above right from 10th standard. There are certain students who may not be above 60% in 10th or 12th. And even in the college, in your engineering program, they may ask you above 7.5 CGP sometimes. Okay, or 7 above. Then there are certain students who will be below than that. Okay, below 7. So that in that case, they may not be able to attend the interview. So this may be cases with certain level of companies, not with all the companies. So based on that, you will be what chosen for the drive. Okay. And then there is no knowledge about the job opportunities in your field of study. So see, for example, if I'm studying, for example, automobile engineering, you need to know what is the target industry I have to go, and what sort of the jobs available for me. And you need to initially when you're doing in the college days itself, you must research about that and you have to work for that. So what are the things or what are the skills I need to develop so that I can get into that particular job? Okay, but the thing is, most of the students are not having this sort of knowledge about what are the jobs available. They simply get into one particular bunch like IT industry at the final very end. That's it. Okay. So I'm not telling that you should not get into IT industry, but see to that your core companies are there, and compared to IT industry, other core companies have very less number of intakes. If you take Ashok Leyland, year-wise, they'll take only 25 students throughout the globe as their freshers entry. Very, very less percentage. See, out of the 1 year, they will consider only 25 students throughout the globe. Sorry, throughout India. So the very less percentage only they'll be getting into the core companies. Okay, so that opportunity you should not miss it. So try to get some opportunities in private sector also. Another thing, main thing, analytical skills. Okay, this thing we will discuss, like quantitative aptitude, all the skills you need to upgrade. Okay, and then communication problem, since most of you does not have fluency in your language. Okay, so this factor will be in a vital role in your rejection process. Okay, so the communication is one of the biggest obstacles that the students are facing. Some may be good in communication, they may be able to clear the round, but some may not be good in communication. Another thing, fear. They'll have percentage, they'll have all the knowledge and everything, but the thing is, they'll have the fear that I won't get selected. That might be reason that they won't they won't even attend the placement. Or if they do attend the placement, they are out of the fear, they will not clear the round. Another thing, and most famous thing, is the laziness. Okay, that I will get the job. From the beginning itself, they have the laziness. They won't be having a proper resume. They won't be preparing well for the interview. So these are all the various factors that leads to your failure in the placement. Do you agree with this, all of you? You're all there?
Yes.
Okay. I could see only one voice from that other side. Not.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We are there, sir.
Okay, fine. So any other points, sir, that you can add to this particular slide regarding your failure in placement, or what may be the factor that is a reason for not getting placed?
Even the particular person may not have a proper guidance, sir.
That is also fine. From our side, we can say, being a teacher, I could say that from our side also, if there is no proper input, okay, for example, from the first year to the third year or the final year, when you don't get a proper guidance, that's absolutely a very good point to be noted here. When you don't get a proper guidance, you won't be knowing about what is happening in the industry or how to get placed. So that might be a very good factor. Your good name?
Divyashree, sir.
Okay, very good, Divyashree. Then next one, any other points? Okay, so we'll move on to the next one. how am I going to crack this interview? Okay, whatever the company is going to come or whatever the company I'm going to participate. So what sort of a skill I need to have and how I'm going to crack this interview? That is what we are going to do. So these are the various factors you need to have in your as your skill set to in order to clear your interview. First and foremost thing you could see is your technical skill. Okay, whether what major you are, that doesn't matter what stream of engineering you are in, you should have your technical skill in your area of study. Okay, that's the first thing. And second thing, every interview will have an aptitude round, whatever, whether it is IT related or a non-IT related or a government job or a public service examination or whatever UPSC examination, any competitive examination will have aptitude. So you need to have aptitude skill. Then placement grooming, that's the third factor, what are the things that you need for a placement, that sort of a grooming, right from attitude, dress code and everything. Then your soft skill, that communication. Then corporate attitude. So you must know what is the meaning of a corporate and then corporate environment, how we have to behave, how we have to get into a corporate, all these factors. Then interview skills. What are the various rounds are there in an interview and what are the skills are required for each and every round that I have to clear. And the real-time internship. There are certain people will go on for a internship programs before getting placed. Okay, so they do get industry exposure and they'll get skilled in that particular area. Okay, so these are the various skills, or I could say some factors that you need to consider before attending the interview. Okay, is there any other point that you can add up here in this particular slide? Or is it sufficient enough to get placed? Okay, so I think this is sufficient enough. Now, as common interview process, recruitment process is concerned, you'll have first a communication round. They'll test your communication. Since if it is an MNC company, definitely you have to speak. Okay, so when you have to speak, then they have to test your communication. That communication may be of different genres. You'll have the genres of rounds. Okay, whether it's a one-to-one communication or a voice audio round, or it may be a group discussion, whatever the thing might be. Okay, then you'll have an aptitude. The aptitude itself, you'll have logical reasoning, verbal reasoning and quantitative aptitude. Then you might be having your technical round. It depends on what company that you're going to go in. That sort of a technical, they'll test you. And finally, you'll have the HR round. Okay, which is the most important round that will fetch you the job. Okay, so apart from this, what are the basic requirements for an interview? So if you're going to prepare for an interview, so these are the various factors you need to have. And the first and foremost thing I should say is positive mind. Before attending any interview, you should have a positive mind that I have to get into this particular company. So you should have a positive mind. Then the research about the company. So whichever company you're going to attend, for example, next week you're going to get Wipro as your campus placement. So you have to research about that particular company called Wipro. What is their current projects? What are the thing they have done so far? And what project they have currently done? What is their recent profit? All those things you have to research. Okay. And then you should have multiple copies of your resume. Whenever you're getting ready for the placement, you should have multiple copies of your updated resume. Here I want to make a point here. You should prepare your own resume. Okay. Don't copy from your friends, because he might be having very good knowledge in certain areas. You may not have. Am I right? Okay, for example, in their hobbies, they might have written I have some reading habit. I love Chetan Bhagat's novel. I love, for example, Shakespeare novels. But this guy who is copying from that particular person won't have any sort of knowledge about that. Okay, so if they ask you a question on that, definitely you won't be answering it. Okay, for example, you might have heard about Chetan Bhagat. How many of you know about Chetan Bhagat?
I know, sir.
Apart from you?
I also know, sir.
Oh, I also know. Can you name at least 4 books written by Chetan Bhagat?
3 Mistakes of My Life.
3 Mistakes of My Life.
Indian Girl. Half Girlfriend, Two States.
Then? That's all. Which was his first book? among the names you have mentioned, which was the first book written by Chetan Bhagat? I think that was the most highest sell.
I guess 5.6.
Yes, 5.1. Okay, so the 5.1 is a book which was converted, or I could say made into a movie called Three Idiots in Bollywood, and then later it was remade in Tamil as I think Nanban. Okay, so it's a Chetan Bhagat novel inspired story only, which was directed by Shankar and Amir Khan in the north. Okay, so these sort of knowledge you must have. If you are mentioning I am a cricket player, I love to play cricket, then you need to know somebody in cricket and some role model in a cricket. Now answer me this question. For example, you don't know anybody as your role model. You don't have anything in your mind as your role model. But in the interview, if they are asking you this question, who is your role model? What might be your answer? You cannot say no. Am I right? You don't have any idea about your role model. Imagine that the scenario is like this. You don't have any role model in your life. Suppose, okay, you don't have anybody in like famous celebrities, whoever it might be. But suddenly this question was asked in the interview. How will you answer this question? You need to answer. You should not give any negative answer. Now, how do you answer this question? Can anyone?
I'll say my father.
You say your?
Father.
Okay. For example, you say your father is your role model. They'll ask you how. Am I right?
As he is an entrepreneur, I'm just seeing from my childhood regarding his hard work and smart work which he has implemented in his day-to-day life.
That's good. So, can we have any other answer? Even for example, those who are not good in communication, how will you answer this question? Those who don't have this much of knowledge, for example, the one who gave the answer, she has very good knowledge and so she has very good communication. That's the reason she's very she has given the answer correctly. Okay, anybody else? Sir, this much of English I don't know, sir. I cannot answer this much, sir. So what sort of a simple answer I could say? Can anyone?
We can say my mother as a role model.
Okay, why?
Because she is very patient. If any issue came to us also, she'll solve it in an easy manner and she'll give us an idea in everything. You can do it in this way.
Okay,
so we can say our mother.
Can we have any other answer? Much simpler than this. Because 2 to 3 lines is very hard for the students. Am I right? Okay.
She is optimistic.
Okay, optimistic. Okay, very good. Actually, whatever the answers you have given so far, it's very good. Okay, let me just put you value add to this particular question. Okay, in a simple way, if somebody is asking you who is your role model, not somebody, in the interview, if you are getting this question, who is your role model, you can say your family members. Okay, either brother, sister, father, mother, uncle, aunt, whoever it might be, and tell them. They'll ask why. You tell them the reason that they taught me what is life is all about. That's very simple. Only one line answer. That itself includes all the factors. They taught me what is life is all about. That's it. Okay. In a simple answer that you can see. Okay. So next, all these things we will discuss now. So you need to have other credentials like mark statement, photographs, passport size photographs, and you need to have your skills like communication, analytical and technical skill, and the knowledge about what you have written in the resume. This is what I'm insisting you to look very seriously. You should have knowledge about what you have written in your resume. So whatever the content is there in your resume, from that only they'll ask you the question. No question apart from your resume will be thrown at your face. And then you have to be very punctual regarding your interview. You have to go on time, on or before that time, and grooming that you all very pretty much very well about the placement, like interview. You have to go in a formal wear. Okay, you cannot go in a casual wear. Okay, after getting into the company, you can wear formal or what casual depends upon the company's rules. Okay, so when you're attending the interview, you have to follow what the protocol. Okay, regarding your dress code, so don't show off yourself in the interview. Okay, and make your answer as simple as possible. Okay, so these are the various requirements, as I can say. And then when you talk about group discussion, okay, that might be one of the thing that you may get in your interview process. So a group discussion may have 5 to 10 members. Nowadays, since the competitors are very high, they even may have 20 members in a group. Okay, among the 20 members in a group, they'll take only one candidate out of the group, or they even may not take any candidate if the communication skill is very poor in that. Okay, so in a group discussion, they'll give you a topic, okay, where you have to, they'll give you at least 5 minutes of time to prepare for the topic. Then, first of all, you'll be put in a team. The team may have what, 15, 10, 15 or 20 members. Topic will be given, 3 to 5 minutes of time will be given to discuss about the topic. Then they'll say, you can start. Anybody can start. In this case, there are three categories I can separate the students, like one who has good communication skill, another who has good communication skill but he has a fear to start first, and the third one, no knowledge about the topic and don't have any communication skill. So these are the three categories I can separate the students. The last category is the worrying factor, because he won't have any knowledge about the topic also. And then the thing is, he won't be having, he or she won't be having the good communication skill. But the first thing, like one who has a good communication skill, he will definitely maintain the show. Like he can talk anything about the topic. But the thing is, group discussion is entirely different from debate. We should not make what group discussion as a debate. Debate is something you can oppose the point, but in a group discussion, you should not oppose or you should not fight with your opponents. And there are various factors you need to know about what are the things you can do in a group discussion. Like, you have to listen through the subject carefully when somebody speaks, and then you have to note down all the points in a scribbling pad or something like that. And then you can, if you know the subject very well, you can start first. Okay, if you know the topic very well, then you can start first, and you should not talk more than 30 seconds. Okay, and you have to give chance to others also. Okay, and you have to speak politely, and you have to respect others' points also. Even they may giving you a wrong answers. Okay, but don't oppose their point. You stick on with your point, what you want to convey. Okay, and then very important point, don't talk too much in the group discussion. Just be simple and stick on with the time. Okay, so then. Okay, don'ts, I missed out the here. Don'ts, in the sense I told you already, like you should not make a debate, and see to that one who is not good in communication. Okay, he may watch fully what is happening in the group discussion. At the final minute, he has to do only one thing. He has to see the time. For example, the timing is given for the group discussion is 5 minutes. Up to 4th minute, he has to watch what are the points that is being discussed. He can write it on a paper. And then at the end of the minute, last minute, he can say, let me conclude. I would like to conclude, because nobody will be aware of time. They will keep on speaking. That is, they want to contribute their points, but they won't be seeing the time. So time is a very, very important factor in a group discussion that can be taken care by the student who is having not having good communication. He can say that I would like to conclude this particular discussion by summarizing all the points which is discussed already. Your group members might have discussed certain points that you might have wrote down. You can see and you can say that point and just conclude the show. Then that will be a major factor that make you to what clear the round. Because I had an experience in Cognizant where when I was attending the interview in the group discussion, I had 20 members. Among the 20 members, they selected only 2 members. Among the 2, I was among the 1. Okay, so that's the reason I'm telling you the competition will be very high. And another thing I want to tell you, communication is not the biggest problem that you face today, because whatever you are seeing in the television or online media, everybody talks in English. So if you watch that itself, you can easily able to grasp all the fluency, the phonetics and the grammar, everything. Even I'm from a rural background only. Now you can see, at least I'm speaking some sort of English. I may not be good in English, but see that I'm also from a village background, and I've transformed myself into a position where I can able to speak in English. Okay, during my school days and all, we don't used to speak in English at all. Now you see how I am speaking, and how much of effort and the things I have put in my life to come to this point. Okay, so I'm just giving you some tips to improve your communication. Okay, so these are the don'ts in a group discussion. You should not argue or shout. And when you mention some fact and figures, don't give any wrong factors. Okay. So these are the things you have to mention in your group discussion. And then comes to aptitude rounds. These are the various chapters that are there in quantitative aptitude. It's like number system, starting from number system, speed and distance, time and work. And then conclusion is height and distance. From this, I could say there are certain areas like, wait a minute. So most important is this thing, ratio, propositions, percentages, and then I could say probability, permutation, combination, okay, and then simplification, and then there are certain things which is not there, speed and distance, okay, and then age problem, problems on ages is there, no, so you can add that, problems on age, sorry, problems on ages. Okay, problem on ages. Then the next one you can add even blood relation question. Blood relation problems. Okay, so these are the various topics that you need to prepare for your placement. See, if you are good in this particular all the chapters, definitely you'll get a job. Either you'll get a industry oriented job, or you can become a personal freelance aptitude trainer. You can take online classes. You could see a lot of online education portal like Unacademy, Udemy, where they concentrate on placement aptitude skills, how to prepare for bank examination, how to clear CAT exam, how to clear this UPSC exams. All this thing, the aptitude plays a vital role. So if you're good in this thing, you can become a trainer where you can earn not less than 5,000 per day. I'm telling you, in Chennai itself, you can become a freelancer. There are plenty of opportunity to become an aptitude trainer where per day you can earn around 5,000 rupees. Okay, so concentrate in all the topics. Among these topics only, they'll be asking questions. Okay. Okay, now we'll solve some exercises. Now tell me what will be the answer for this question. A fruit seller had some apples. He sells 40% apples and still has 420 apples remaining. So originally, how many apples he might have had? Tell me the answer for this. Can anyone? So if you, anybody know the answer for this? 588. Okay, now let me solve, since we don't have much time. Okay, let x be the number of apples. We don't know how much apple we have, so x be the apples. Okay, among that apples which the fruit seller had, 40% of apples have been sold. Okay, so totally 100%. So I could say 100% minus 40. Out of 100%, 40% has been sold out of what? X apples. Am I right? And the remaining apples is equal to 420. So 100 is a total percentage of apple. In that, 40% is sold. Okay. So this much percentage has been sold of X apples. Okay. And the remaining apple happens to be 420. So 60% of X is equal to 420. So from this, how can we calculate X? X will be what? 420 into 100. Since 60% can be written as 60 by 100. Okay, we can write the 60% as 60 by 100. So 100 divided by what? 60. So cancel 0 here, 0 here. And then this one, 1 times, and here 7 times 42, 70. So into 10. So therefore 700 apples. So originally he had how many apples? 700 apples. Can you able to understand this question?
Yes, sir.
All of you? Is there any doubts in this particular sum? Or my solution is clear for you?
Yes, sir.
Is anyone want me to explain in Tamil for you if you're having any problem in communication?
It's clear, sir.
Okay, fine, good. Now let me move to the next sum. Okay, now answer to the question. This is a very famous question pointing to a photograph. Okay, this is a famous blood relation question. Okay, pointing to a photograph. Okay, Arun said, okay, he is the son. He is the son of the only daughter of the father of my brother. Okay, how Arun is related to the man in the photograph? Okay, this is the question. So they have given four options. What might be the answer for this? Now, I'll tell you the trick to solve this one. Okay, you need to know this blood relation, all the blood relation like father, mother, then grandfather, grandmother, okay, and then grandson, okay, granddaughter, then maternal uncle and paternal uncle. What is maternal uncle and what is paternal uncle? See, the
mommy's side uncle is maternal uncle and daddy's side uncle is
daddy's side brother or brothers, we can say it is a paternal uncle. Mother's side brother sister we call it as maternal, and father's side brother sister we call it as paternal, and then father's sister may be called as paternal aunt. Father's brother is called as paternal uncle. Similarly, mother's brother, elder brother or younger brother is called as maternal uncle. Similarly, mother's sister, elder sister or younger sister is called as maternal aunt. Okay. In Tamil, we easily know. But the problem is, we doesn't know. Somebody might be won't be knowing this. And what about the nephew and niece? Can anyone say? Nephew and niece.
Sir, if a brother or sister's daughter or son, their daughter means their niece, son means their nephew.
Is it right? Correctly? Can you put it correctly? Nephew and niece. Who is called as nephew and who is called as niece?
Sister or brother's son.
Pardon?
Sister or brother, son.
Okay. So, if it's a brother or sister, son. Then
niece is a female, nephew is a male.
Okay. So, you put it in a sentence format. Okay.
Brother's son is called nephew and brother's daughter is called niece.
Okay. That's it. Okay, fine. Good. That's right. Now, we'll see this question, how to solve this question. Now, after seeing this question, as a beginner, you'll be getting confused. He is the son of the only daughter of the... Before that, you need to know the blood relation diagram. What is a blood relation diagram means? If the relation is on the same level, for example, husband and wife will be on the same level, like husband and wife will be on the same level, and they'll be indicated with a diagram like this. Okay, and then the father and the mother, okay, so they'll be on the same line, like a husband and wife. Okay, and then son means one level below. If a father has a son, then you have to put it in the second level, and grandson you have to put it in the next level. So likewise, how we are going to solve this problem, you see here. Okay, once again. Now, when you see the pointing to a photograph, Arun said. Now, note down who has said or who has told Arun. So, make a point here, Arun. And in the quotation marks, the which is given, find the word where is my, and after what is given, my brother. So, now you can relate this Arun with this thing. So, Arun has a brother. Arun has a brother. So, brother usually masculine, male will be denoting as a rectangle box. Female means will be denoting as a circle. So, Arun has a brother. So, first you find the name. Okay, from that, this quotation mark, they'll be giving the relation. In that, find the word my brother. First of all, my. The word my. What is the relation given after that? So, that you have to relate with the Arun or whoever that is given before said. Okay, so Arun said my brother. So he is a brother. Okay, my brother. From there, go friend. Brother and then father. Whose father? Brother's father. Okay, so brother has a father. Okay, brother's father. So brother's father means go a level up because he is a father. And then from there you go father's daughter. So your father, from that his daughter. So already this father has a son, now a daughter. Okay, then from daughter go there only son. So that daughter has a only son. So son means rectangle. Okay, now what is the, and now we have completed the entire quotation starting from my. So my brother, so Arun's brother, and brother's father. Father had a daughter, daughter's only son. Now the question, how Arun is related to the man in the photograph? Now, how is Arun related to the man in the photograph? Tell me.
Nephew.
He is the only son. This is the thing. Okay, he is the only son. So, this son, which one? This son, how he is related to Arun? This is the question. Can you say, this son has a mother, okay, mother's brother. So, can I say maternal uncle? Can you
yes.
See, the Arun said he is the only son. So here we have to find that only son. Whose only son? The only son is from the daughter. Whose daughter? The father of my brother. So Arun has a brother who has a father, and a father has a daughter, only daughter, who has a only son. Okay, so how you have to relate this son and the Arun? This only son and Arun. So Arun's sister's son only, this guy. So how Arun's sister's son, Arun has a sister. Now only I told you, if it is a mother's side, then you have to call as maternal. So mother's brother is only Arun. So this guy has a relation as mother's maternal uncle. Can you able to understand?
Yes.
All of you clear? See, you have to, when you draw this diagram, it will be very easy for you to clear. Okay. Now moving on to this question, answer to this question. Similar problem. Okay, now I have given some relationship. From that, I am asking among the four answer, which answer is the right one? Which indicates what? H is the grandson of P. Now, randomly, since we are running out of time, I randomly take this D as the answer. Now, first of all, what is A plus B? A plus B means A is the sister of B. And what is A into B? That is, A is the father of B. What is A divided by B? A is the brother of B. Now you see this D, option D, and you take this, what is K plus P? K is the sister of P. So K is the sister of P. So P may be anybody, who may be a male or a female, but K is the sister. So definitely it is a female. Okay, so here let me assume that it is a brother. Okay, so this is the same level. Then after K plus P, P into D. So what is A cross B? Means A is the father of B. Here P cross D. P cross D is P is the father of whom? D. And then what is the next? D cross H. So D cross H means again father. Okay. So D is the father of H. And H cross M. And then H is the father of M. Now what is the relation they are asking? Which of the following expression, H is the grandson of P? Now you see H. H is the grandson of P. Is it satisfying? H has a father D. D has a father P. So P's grandson is whom? H. Can you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Are you clear on this?
Yes, it's clear.
Okay. You can refer other thing also. It won't be satisfying. Since I am running out of time, I have solved this one. Okay. So we will go into the next one. Answer this question. A bag contains 3 red, 4 white and 5 black balls. So totally how many balls are there in a bag? 3 plus 4, 7. 7 plus 5 is 12. 12 balls are there. And 3 balls are drawn at random. Okay. So I am going to take 3 balls from the total balls. And what is the probability that all the ball is different? So 3 balls, what I am taking is 3 different balls, that is one is red, one is white and one is black. So what might be the answer? This is the answer. out of 12 balls, I need to pick the three balls. So that's the first total outcome. Now you could see here, out of the total balls, 12 balls, I need to take 3 balls. So here 12C3 you have to find. Okay, what is the formula for combination? 12 into 11 into 10 divided by 3 into 2 into 1. So this will give you what? 6 and then 1 times, 4 times, 1 times, 2 times, 2 into 11 is 22, 220. So the answer is 220. So here not 165, it is 220. And number of favorable outcomes. I need to, among the 3 balls, each ball should be what? Unique, different colors. So there is 3 what? Red balls, from that I have to take 1. And then 4 next color ball, I have to take 1. And among 5 black balls, I need to take 1. So when you find out 3C1, 4C1, 5C1, it will be 60. So what is the total probability? Total probability is equal to number of favorable outcomes divided by the total outcome. So it will be what? 60 divided by 220. So when you solve this, 6 by 22, which will be 3 by 11. So answer is 3 by 11. Can you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now we have a lot of thing, but since we are running out of time, okay, let me just try to answer this one. It's a very recently asked interview question. The number of ways a word aptitude can be arranged. The number of ways a word aptitude can be arranged. So totally how many letters are there in this word? A, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 letters are there. How many combinations of words are thing you, that you can form? See, this question, there are two genres. One is when they ask you to what find the number of ways a word aptitude can be arranged. Okay, with repetition or without repetition. This problem is categorized into two types. One is with repetition. With repetition, okay. Another one is without repetition. Okay, without repetition. Okay, so if without repetition, the first one, so you count the number of letters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the answer is 8 factorial. Very simple. So the answer is 8 factorial. What is 8 factorial? 8 into 7 into 6 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Sorry, 5 into 4 into 3 into 1. So you try to memorize from 1 factorial to 8 factorial in order to easily manipulate the answers. Okay, so 8 factorial is the answer. Suppose with repetition, if they are asking, see here, T is repeated twice. Am I right? With repetition of letters, if they are asking you in the question, see that any letters are repeated, here T is repeated. So here with repetition means this particular sum. Okay, you need to answer like this. 8 factorial, that is total number of letters factorial divided by number of repetition, which letter T is repeated for 2 times, so 2 factorial. So 8 factorial divided by 2 factorial will be the answer for this one. Can you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is one genre of question that they may ask you. Okay, now this is the formula I gave. Okay, in case of non-repeated letters, you can simply find the number of letters factorial. That's the answer. In case of repeated letters, you could see number of ways a word can be formed is equal to number of letters divided by number of repeated letters. So total number of letters, that is what 8 factorial divided by 2 factorial in the previous slide. Okay. Now this thing quite easy. Okay. We will discuss after this. Okay. If we have time. Now, what is the best career option after engineering? Okay. Some might be interested in pursuing higher studies. Okay. So if you are interested in higher studies like ME, MTech, okay, you have to definitely clear GATE exam. Okay, so for GATE exam, you need to prepare for that exam. Okay, so recently they have conducted 2021 GATE exam. One last update they have given is even the third year students can also write the GATE exam. So previously, until 2020, only the final year students and the degree holders can attend. Now they have introduced a new update, like third year students can also participate in what GATE examination, and you can have any number of attempts. So start preparing for the GATE examination if you want to pursue higher study. Even for the PSU, that is public service undertaking, like BEL, BC, BPCL, okay, and then ONGC, any government sectors you want to get into it, you need to have your GATE score, okay, prepare well for that. Some might be interested in management, like MBA, they might be interested in MBA, so they can what do CAT or GMAT examination, okay. So prepare well for the CAT examination, go for some coaching centers, or you can prepare by your own if you are good in aptitude, okay. If you are not good in aptitude, you need some extra training, you can go to any training institute where they can give you good guidance for your CAT examination. Then you can start up your own business. How many of you know about this franchise Chai Kings in Chennai? How many of you know about Chai Kings? Have you tasted a cup of chai in Chai Kings? Anyone? No answer from your side? Are you all there?
No, sir.
You didn't have, you, nobody from your class haven't tasted a cup of chai from Chai Kings?
Yeah, I
heard it,
sir.
You did?
Yes, sir. Long back, but.
And have you heard about the story behind the owner of Chai Kings?
It was a long time ago, I guess. Went with my brother, they are saying something. I was
visiting my brother. All of you just Google it. Okay, who is the owner of Chai Kings and how he came into this particular business? Okay, he was working in an IT company, then start up his own business, that is Chai Kings. So nowadays, I would recommend my students, okay, instead of getting into a company and working for salary, you can become an own entrepreneur. Okay, you can start up your own business and you can what earn much more money than your what salary. Okay, that is my suggestion. Each everyone will have a different opinion, and then become an expert. Like you can develop a skill like the area like artificial intelligence, data science, okay, machine learning, okay, or anything related with the automobile engineering. You can become an expert in CAD tool. So all this thing will fetch you a job. Okay. And then civil services examination, preparing for that and getting into the civil services. And if you are looking for jobs, and if you are very, because it's not easy to get placed in IT, in core companies, then you have to find an internship. I would recommend you to see this particular website, Internsala. How many of you know this? Have you registered yourself in this?
Yes, sir.
Okay, very good. So you just register yourself in Internsala. And then look for internships, and after your successful internship, you can easily get into the core company. So I would recommend you to what register yourself in Inshala, and then try to find out internship in your core companies. Okay, ma. Then if you are IT, if you are want to pursue a career in IT industry, these are the various areas that you have: application developer, web designer, web developer, database administrator, network engineer, mobile app development, then you can become a data scientist, data analyst, big data engineer, machine learning engineer. And similarly, if you are ending up in a customer support executive job, then you need to do the backend process. Like for that, you need to have the knowledge about MS Office, that is especially MS Excel. See, I would recommend you to learn MS Excel, that to advance Excel, everybody, you try to do some course on Udemy, okay, regarding advanced Excel. Because every student need to know about Excel, okay. So because in every organization, we would definitely work in Excel, okay. So you better you try to what learn Excel. That will be much better what option for you. Okay, regarding other things like application developer, C++, Java, because since it is something related to the IT field, so since many stream students are there, I don't want to deeply get into this. Okay, how many of you there IT from IT now? Is there from a CSE?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So this slide may be an interesting, useful slide for you. Okay. So these are the various category of job. All cannot be a programmer. All cannot be a good programmer. Okay. All won't be good having good knowledge in programming. So you can choose your area. Either you can go in web designing. If you are good in HTML, CSS, and JavaScript, basic level of HTML, like these languages, then you can easily become a web designer. Even you can go into UI and UX designer, latest trending job, UI and user interface design job, that is user, okay. So that is what I've given here in the last part, UI and UX designer. For that, if you have a HTML, CSS and JavaScript skill, then you can become this particular designer. And then if you have good knowledge about the systems in the companies, then you can become a system analyst. Okay, and then software consultant, like the company might be in need of certain softwares for their processing, okay, business process. So you can suggest them these are the softwares they can purchase, they can have. So that is the area called software consultant. This is most of the line where people are unaware about it. Okay, then software quality analyst, like a basic level of testing, test engineer jobs, where if you are good in SQL commands, Linux command and automation, testing automation tools like Selenium, all those things, you can get into this job. Okay. And another thing, the database administrator. And if you're looking for a career in Oracle, then you can write this examination, like certification exam, OCA and OCP. Okay. And even Microsoft provides SQL Server certification exams for database administration. And regarding the network engineer, you can go ahead with CCNAs in CCNP certification. At least minimum level of CCNA is enough, because CCNP is quite costly. Okay, you can go ahead with CCNA certification. And for application development, you can go ahead with what? If you want to get into Java line, you can do some OCJP certification from Oracle. And then if you are interested in mobile app development, then I would recommend you to learn Kotlin. Okay, which is like a Java based language. Kotlin is a very trending language recently. And then if you want to become iOS app developer, then you have to learn Swift. That is, previously it was Objective-C, now it is Swift. Okay, so these are the various areas that you have in IT as a career, because most of the companies, you'll get IT companies coming at your place. So you have to choose any of this area, and then you can go in as an entry level. If you are a mechanical student or EEE student, so what is the basic language you have learned during the first year? I think foundation of computers, what language you have learned, all the engineering students?
Python.
Okay, then I would recommend you to complete at least a basic level of Python. So they may be asking you questions from Python. They may be asking you questions from Python, if whatever the computer languages that you have gone through, might be C, C++ also, that might be an option. Okay, so Python is latest language, so you might be getting question from that. If you're mentioning Python alone in your resume, then they may ask you question from Python. Otherwise, they may ask you from C, C++, Java, based on your interest. Okay, but IT students, you need to thorough the subject. What are all the things that you got in your syllabus? From that, you whatever you're mentioning in your resume, they'll be asking you the questions. Okay, so these are the various areas that I mentioned, like Kotlin and then Swift and then R, Python, Java and HTML, CSS, JavaScript. So which programming language I need to learn first if you want to get into an IT industry? Okay, any of this would fetch you a job. Okay, doesn't matter whichever you want to, but if you want to learn Java, then you need to have knowledge about C and C++. So directly you cannot learn Java, but for Python, there is no need to have any previous languages. Directly you can learn, since a very easy language. Okay, and even Kotlin, you should have some basic about Java, then you can learn Kotlin. And then C# is quite similar to a Java. You see, it is a Microsoft product, this is Oracle product, that's the difference. But most of the coding, if you know any one object-oriented language, then it is easily, you can update to any language. For example, I know C++. Very good. You can easily learn Java. Very easy. You can easily learn PHP. You can easily learn Swift, Kotlin, Ruby, Scala, whatever the language, recent languages, because it is a base. And then if you're good in, I want to go in database line, then SQL is your famous factor. Okay. So these are the trending languages. And if you are attending IT interview, so these are the various things you need to concentrate, like OOPs concept. And then the data structures and algorithms, like some programs you need to know, like sorting program, and then sorting, searching, logic oriented programs. Okay, and some basic concept of operating system and the database management system. Then the programming language of your choice that you might have mentioned in your resume. So these are the fundamentals that you need to have. So here it will be technical round, either it might be one-to-one round, okay, or it might be a technical MCQ. Like you might be writing an online test, okay, where you will be giving some, will be given some MCQs, okay, or there you will be sitting in front of an interviewer, he might be asking you some questions. So these are the two various factors. Okay, so these are the various programs I do have. What is the time now? So it is already 5:05. How long I can proceed, Ramya or Dhanalakshmi? Can anyone help me? How long I can proceed?
Sir, it's up to you. We shall maximum for 5:15. Also, if you wish to, you can take it, sir.
Okay, 5:15 up to 5:15, or 5 minutes beyond that, I can take.
It's up to you, sir. If you want to conclude, you can conclude it here, or if you want to extend, you can extend.
No, sir. I thought of extending because I need to give some MCQs. That's the reason I'm asking. Because since if you are sticking up with the time, I have to complete. That's the reason.
Okay, okay, sir. You can proceed with it, sir.
Okay. For example, can anyone answer this question? It's a quite a C language question. Okay. How many of you know C here? Or you tell me whether from C, C++, Java, these three, which language I can ask you? Or Python, fourth one. You tell me, I'll ask you the question. I need answer from your side, or else we do one thing. Okay, now can you write the program for the first question in Python? How will you swap two numbers without using temporary variable? Can you write a program for this question?
Yes, sir.
A comma B is equal to B comma A.
A comma B is equal to?
B comma A.
Can we have any other answers? A comma B is equal to B comma A. So, I'll just
swap A comma B.
Is there any other way we can find do swapping process? Can you see the Python interpreter? So as you have mentioned, A 10, then B is equal to 20, then A comma B is equal to B comma A. So now you print A comma B. You'll be getting what, 20 and 10. This is the right answer. Okay, this is one of the right answers, a very famous way. Is there any other option that we can do for swapping? Is there any other solution? Okay, that you can is there any other solution for finding the swapping of two numbers?
So you're asking without using temp or any other method is
available? Yes, without using temp.
Like addition, subtraction.
Okay, that is famous. Okay, any other thing apart from that? For example, now let me just, what is A? It is 20. What is B? It is 10. Now, see here, A is equal to A. And then B is equal to, again A is equal to. Now you print A and then print B, whether it's swapped or not. So you can do with the help of bitwise operator. This operator is called XOR operator. Okay, you might have learned during your school days logical operators, logic gates. So XOR operator, when both the inputs are different, like 1 and 0, you'll get the output as 1. Okay, so you can use XOR operator to perform what? Swapping operation. Okay, so here I have used three lines, A equal to A XOR B, B equal to A XOR B, again A equal to A XOR B. So these three lines will make the numbers to get swapped. Okay, so these are the various ways that you can what perform swapping. Okay, any other solution is there for this? Okay, and then famous next, I could say some pattern printing exercises. Okay, see, these are some pattern printing exercises which is usually asked in TCS, Infosys, Wipro, Accenture. They'll ask this pattern printing problem. Okay, either in any of the language that you have studied very well, maybe in C, C++, Java or Python. So, can anyone do this particular pattern? Knowledge about creating patterns? So I'm opening a Python script. Okay, I'm doing with Python only. So I'm taking the number of for x in range 1, 5, and then for, I'll explain, don't worry, for y in range 1, x+1. Okay, and then just print, okay, just asterisk, comma, end equal to space, and then print a new line. That's all. Now you save this file. py is the Python extension. Then you could run this file, so you could see the pattern. Can you see the pattern?
No, sir.
So what is the logic behind this is, now this range is like a loop starting from first line to 5 means n minus 1, that is up to 4. When you give a range function works like 1 to whatever the ending value you are giving, minus 1 it will go. So 1 comma 5 means 1 to 4 it will go. So I'm going to print from first line to fourth line. Okay, so that is my process. Then this while loop is for what has to be printed in each line. So first line I have to print 1 asterisk. Second line, I have to print 2 asterisk. Third line, I have to print 3 asterisk. Fourth line, I have to print 4 asterisk. So each and every line depends on this X loop. Okay. So here, very famous, you can say I and J. So I loop for the number of lines and J loop for the number of stars or values that is presented. So that you can write it as a comment. Okay. So I number of lines and J what has to be printed. Why I'm giving J plus 1 here is, because each line depends on I. Sorry, here I plus 1. So each line depends on I. So first line means you have to print 1 asterisk only. Second line means 2 asterisk. So each J depends on I value. So 1 to I. That is I plus 1 means up to I it will print. And here print asterisk. And if I don't give end equal to end, how to format this end? If I'm giving simply like that, each time the asterisk will be printed on new line, so you could see on every line. Okay, so this is not the proper output, so I'm saying don't go to the new line, same on the remain on the same line. So I'm giving the end attribute as space. So if you give like this, then it will definitely what go from one line to second line. After finishing the second line, it'll go to the third line. After finishing the third line, it'll go to the fourth line. Even see, instead of asterisk here, you could change it to something like instead of asterisk, I'm printing J here. If I print J here, see the output, I get another pattern 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4. You could see here, the first pattern I have finished, even the second pattern I have finished. Okay, so similarly, I can even draw a lot of patterns. If I give I here, okay, so I could see here, I here, then I'll get 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3, 4, 4, 4, like that. Okay, so this is another pattern. Even I can change it to what, for example, Mm. I am declaring a variable as x is equal to 65. Okay, each time I'm printing x, so it will, what will be the output? We'll be getting 65 65 65. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to increment each time plus equal to 1. Okay, so now if I run 65 65 66 like that, you'll be getting, but I need to get the characters a b c d like that pattern. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give a character type here, convert that given integer to a character, and then you run it again. You could see a b c a b c d. Then you can add a space here. Okay, even printing this, you can add a space in between here. So you could see a b a b c a b c d like that. Even from z you can do it. Okay, if I give 90 and then here I could see instead of plus equal to I can give minus equal to. Okay, and then if I run it, you could see z z y z y x like that I can see. So can you able to understand? This is one of the famous IT related question they may ask you, that is pattern printing exercises. Okay, now I'll have question from your side. You can ask questions. With that, we'll conclude.
It's your time now. You can ask any queries or any questions to the speaker. You can unmute yourself or you can just type it in the chat box. It's your time now.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
Actually, I am from CNC department. If we are closing our placement offers or internships on the field of IT, which one will you prefer, sir? A service-oriented companies or a product-based companies?
It doesn't matter whether it is a service oriented or a product oriented. It depends on your interest. See, it is your interest that is the major factor. Okay, if you are interested in service oriented company, you can go into a service oriented company. Or if you are interested in product oriented company, then you can. It depends on your interest. It is not. This is my suggestion. My suggestion would be, it is based on your interest and passion, which area you have to go, and you have to develop the skills related to that.
Okay, sir. And one more thing, you have just mentioned for developing an application that Kotlin is a user friendly one.
Yes.
What about Flutter, sir?
Pardon?
Comparing Kotlin and Flutter.
Like Flutter is now even recently, like it is a generic kind of a language where you can develop both iOS and Android apps using Flutter. Okay, so even you can learn Flutter, that's not a problem. Then see, I'm telling you very simply, if you know any basic object oriented programming language like C++ or Java, then you can get into any languages.
Okay, sir.
Okay, I hope I have answered your question.
Yes, sir.
Yes, next. Is there any other question?
Participants, if you have any doubts or any further queries, you can ask the speaker.
Whether the session was boring or it is useful for you?
Based on my personal opinion, it was really an eye-opening session for us, because at the start, I didn't expect it would be this much useful for us. You shared a lot of insights with us, just also from the start. Stating our mistakes and what are the drawbacks from our side till the staff side, and also showed us a wide range of applications and what are the basic questions, any examples. It was very interesting for us. You kept us engaging throughout the session, sir. We're thankful for that.
Yeah, actually, to be honest, I couldn't complete the lot of things I want to share with you, but since the 1 hour is the time constraint for us, I have to stick on with the time, you know. Like, I thought of solving a lot of aptitude questions and then technical related side and some HR, funny, interesting HR question I want to share. But the thing is, I couldn't able to since the time is very limited. But that is why I am asking you this question, whether the session was good, whether it is informative, whether you have got some knowledge about it or not.
Yeah, so it was very, very interesting because without being sharing many things, it's this much, it's interesting. But if you are sharp, those, I guess it would be up to the notch. Because up to this itself, we feel like we are some more informative than yesterday. We have been informated a lot today. So really, we will be planning again a session with you, sir, and that could be more than 1 hour. So that you could be okay with it, sir. We'll be speaking to our student branch counselor and the other staff members, and we'll be intimating you again.
Yeah, sure. Any other feedback from your side? But before feedback, let me ask questions, because the questions are more important than the feedback. I want you to get placed. That's the main motto behind my seminar, okay, or the webinar which I'm coming as a guest. So you guys have to get placed in a good company. So you need to know, okay, what are the things that you need to groom. So I need questions from your side so that I can help you to get placed.
I guess the participants are remaining silent because you are very crystal clear in your presentation, explaining us all.
Okay.
So,
and kind information, I've been freelance trainer for Rajalakshmi Engineering College and Rajalakshmi Institute of Science from 2011 to 2015. Each and every time before they're getting placed, they'll have this in employability training camp where I used to go for 8 days and 16 days camp, where I would be sharing some technical session with them. So now we are missing all those things due to this pandemic situation. So as of now, I'm planning to conduct every program online to share my knowledge and how the interview will be, what sort of a thing you need to have. And another thing, definitely you people have to enhance your skills. The degree won't fetch you a job. To conclude, degree won't fetch you a job unless otherwise if you have a skill. Skill is very important. Even a guy who doesn't he did not go to any school or a college, okay, if he has a skill, then he can become a great entrepreneur. Okay, so definitely you are studying in a college, okay, where you are learning a lot of subject. Try to develop your skill in your area of interest. Skill is very important. That is what I insist in all my students. Try to do some certification, but certifications are not mandatory. But I would insist the department to make each and every one of the students to get certified in any of the area in their stream of engineering. Each year you have to complete any one certification, either NPTEL, okay, or from Udemy or Coursera. Try to do some international certification course so that you will be having a par with the students across the globe. You know, there is a salary difference even in the engineering colleges. I heard a Sony company conduct a campus placement on various engineering colleges, like affiliated Anna City colleges, directly on Guindy campus. And so what is the salary difference? All the final year students are all same cadre, but the CEG campus student get 10 lakh per annum. But the affiliated college students get only 4 lakh per annum. See the difference. Okay, so all these factors, and you need to know what is the current industry demands for a fresher. Okay, so what is the highest paid salaries in India? And what are the things that you need to just go through the lot of things on the Google and take down these particular channels for your reference. One is the freshersworld.com. You could see the website and also the YouTube channel, Freshers World. There is a thing it's a particular playlist where they come give a package for placement preparation, all aptitude or all those soft skill or related questions, like how to attend an interview, what sort of question they'll ask in the interview. All a pack of videos are there in the playlist. So kindly make a note of this particular channel named Freshers World, and then feel free to learn. Another channel, his name is Satish, for aptitude. To grooming your aptitude skill, note on this channel name, feel free to learn. And then if you are an IT student, definitely you should have an account in Geeks for Geeks. You might already heard about Geeks for Geeks. So try to access Geeks for Geeks for even for the notes purpose and also for competitive exam preparation. Now that latest buzzword regarding the IT industry is competitive programming, and I recommend all of you to take up this I'll just wind off. Okay, how many of you know about TCS NQT exam?
Yeah, sir.
How many of you have prepared for that?
Uh,
Okay. Well, I guess we have registered it and attended it once last year.
Yes, you have attended. So there are different things that is there in the TCS NQT. So you need to know about the cognitive exam skill and then IT industry subject NQT score. There are various tests you can take up. If you're if your college is having a tie-up with the TCS, then you will get a free of cost. Some coupon is there. Otherwise, you have to attend the test by online by yourself, paying some amount of around 400. And what is the benefit out of this TCS NQT is you are exposure to the recruiters, like famous recruiters, and your scores will be considered for the placement purpose. So I would recommend you to prepare for that, see some sample tutorials regarding that TCS NQT examination, and I wish all of you to get placed, and send me a message that sir, I got placed in a nice company, MNC company, my life is settled. Okay, I should get this. And before ending this, take down my contact details for any personal training and all those So take down my contact details. I have my own channel like in YouTube regarding my technical knowledge sharing purpose. I do go for a lot of webinars as a guest. So I do post it on my YouTube channel, and also I used to put programming language tutorials like Python, Java, okay, so C++, and then data structure, all this thing. So you can refer to my channel, you can subscribe to my channel, so that you'll be getting a lot of news about the webinar, like interview purpose, and also like technical aspects like one has to know. And then these are my various contact details. And you can note it down, my mail ID and my mobile number, and you can contact me regarding your doubts and queries. Okay. Okay, that's all from my side. Okay, and it's up to you to now conclude.
Yeah, sir, just a moment, sir. I just call upon Ramesh to just thank the speaker for just joining us. Over to you, Ramesh.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation, actually. Thanks a lot, sir.
Thank you, Ramya. I should thank you for giving me an opportunity, because all because of you only I got this opportunity to address your students.
Thanks a lot for accepting our invitation. It's really a useful webinar for all of my friends and senior students also. Thank you so much, sir.
Yeah, thank you, Ramya.
Sir, just a moment, sir. As a token of love and appreciation from the Panimala Institute of Technology student branch, we like to present this e-memento to you. I request Ms. Epsiba to present the screen to sir. Epsiba. Sir, I guess the screen is visible to you.
Yeah, thank you so much. I thank the department and the student coordinators for giving me this memento. It is a honor. Okay, it's like overwhelming. Rather than getting money, these are the things that make us proud each and every day. Thank you so much to your department and the college. Okay.
Thank you, sir. Your words are very powerful for us. So to formally conclude the session, I just now call upon Ms. Epsiba to give the vote of thanks. Over to Epsiba.
I'm very much glad to convey my hearty thanks to today's speaker, Mr. M. Muhammad Suhail, for presenting his valuable time for us in presenting the webinar. I could also like to extend my sincere thanks to our beloved student branch counselor, Dr. M. P. Chitra, and our student branch advisor, Dr. M. Arun, IEEE Vice Chairman, TMS Madras Chapter, and Principal Dr. T. Jayanti, for providing us a golden opportunity for organizing this webinar. So participants, if you enjoyed this webinar and feel like participating in more like these events, you are always welcome to follow our social media pages and WhatsApp groups, where we'll update you with the upcoming session. The feedback link is be posted in the chat box. Kindly do fill it within 15 minutes. Thank you once again.
Okay, thank you all once again. I'd like to extend my sincere thank to Panimala Institute of Technology, then the Department of ECE, HOD, Dr. M. Chitra, Madam, and then Mr. Arun, Assistant Professor, ECE Department, and then student coordinators, Ramya Sri Dhanalakshmi, and and others, I don't know their names, okay, who are behind this webinar. And thank to the all the participants from various departments to make this webinar a grand success for me in my career. And also, you keep on asking me doubts to my mail, and you can contact me at any time regarding your placements and all. Okay, see you with the next webinar soon. Okay, thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Can you share the feedback once everyone has given it?
Yes, it will be sent to you WhatsApp by the student coordinator, sir.
Okay, okay. I need to remain here. Can I end this?
Yeah, the session is over, so it's up to you. So you can just also just share your insights, or you can also leave. So it's your wish, sir.
Yeah, I'm inside. Like, I want feedback from your side. Like, if anyone wants to convey anything, like any doubts you can have. I'll just give you 1 or 2 minutes so that I'll close my session.
Okay, so participants, it's your time now. You can just share the feedback how the meet was, so it would be useful for us and also the speaker to improve us from our side. So I wish anyone to volunteer up and give your feedbacks.
Yeah, and one kind advice I want to give to the students is, see, even though we are living in the pandemic situation, our education did not stop. That understand, try to understand that very factor. Okay, we could see so many of them near to us are dying each day and each moment. Okay, but we are blessed by the Almighty that we are getting some opportunity to learn something, to know something regarding our career. So we must be very thankful. Make your time very useful one. Okay, don't just unnecessarily sit on entertainment media and then spend your time useless. Okay, I would ask, like I would suggest you to what? Go through a lot of useful videos and courses regarding your career so that you can improve your skills which you don't have. Okay, that's what I can say. Be safe. Okay, don't roam here and there unnecessarily, even though it is a complete lockdown. Okay, be careful. Regularly wash your hands and wear mask, you know, and then have some hot water, hot items. Okay, do some steaming process each and every day. Keep your health safe. Okay, keep your surrounding also safe. Insist them with a lot of good manners. Okay, so I think that's all for that's all from your side. I don't think you have any doubts here.
I too guess it's the same, because we are keeping everything silent, so I guess they have no doubts.
Okay, then thank you, Krishna, for this wonderful MOU. MC, you have done a great job. Okay, your communication skill is too good. Okay, it's very good. Even Dhanalakshmi and Ramya, everybody has a good communication skill. Try to get placed in big companies and let me know. Okay, thank you all. Okay, take care. Bye-bye.
Sure, sir. Thank you, sir.